If you thought my previous video on installing Windows 7 on a computer that is perfectly capable of running a newer OS was silly, here's something even stupider. Running a newer OS on an older OS on a virtual machine. There are actually some people who do this seriously and think it's a good idea. So this is still my HP 15 with 4th gen Intel Core CPU. It came with Windows 8. It ran Windows 10 most of its life. But now I decided to install Windows 7 on it, and I said I wouldn't be keeping this installation, but for now I still have it. At first I wanted to use Microsoft Virtual PC, which is a bit old but it's simple and powerful, but it doesn't work with OSs newer than Windows Vista or 7. So I installed VMware Workstation 15, which I believe is the newest version that works on Windows 7, and then installed Windows 10. This is an older build, it's what I had in a DVD-R. But it's good enough. It is version 15.11 to be exact. So let's get started. Let's see if we can destroy this Windows 10 installation and repair it without reinstalling. First, let's back up its files. This version of VMware has an option to map the virtual machine disk, so you can see the files in it. We'll mount the largest partition, and there it is. We'll turn off the option to hide protected operating system files. But I will not be backing up the page file and the swap file, because they're virtual memory files. Let's see if we can back up everything else. Okay, I did paste, but it's not doing anything. Maybe let's just do the Windows folder. Okay. Why is it unavailable? It's right there. That's weird. Maybe we can zip it up. Oh wait, access is denied. Don't do it here. Add to archive. Okay, some things say access is denied, but we'll back up what we can. Actually, let's try all the files, not just the Windows folder. This is gonna take a while. In the meantime, we can set up the shared folder. And let's do that VM backup folder. So we'll wait until this is done. Okay, finally it's done. Let's disconnect the virtual disk. Take a snapshot of the virtual machine before destroying it. And start it back up. People still ask me to destroy operating systems. Well, that's not what I do anymore on a regular basis. I decided to do it this time. I have some other ideas for videos, but they're not ready yet. Comunque sì, sono italiano. Anyway, where's the shared folder? There it is. I've also put the 7-zip installer, so I can unzip that zip file. Let's just make sure. Okay, there's everything. And theoretically, we should just be able to extract everything to the C drive. Let's see if the destruction works first. This command deletes every single file on the C drive. Yeah, I'm closer to 30 years old than 20, so that's why I don't find this so entertaining anymore. Doesn't look like there's anything wrong yet. Let's enter full screen. But for some reason it's not adjusting the display resolution. I think 7-zip is gone already. Can we reinstall it? Oh, the background is gone now. Okay, if we can open it, we have a chance to extract the files later. Lots of access denied errors, but it does a lot of damage anyway. I may have to call it a day and resume tomorrow. Okay, it's the next day and look at this corrupted lock screen. It's done. I'm Cortana, I can help you plan. I think I'm gonna doubt that. Windows is done being destroyed. Let's take another snapshot. And first, let's just see what happens when we restart normally. And boom, it crashed. Critical service failed. So let's quickly go back. And I bet you've never seen this error message before. The VMware Tools resume script did not run successfully in this virtual machine. The virtual machine could not be changed to the selected monitor layout. Does it work at least? Seems so. Can we open the zip archive? Okay, we can. Let's examine the destroyed OS a little more. Settings app still works. Can we sign out to be able to change the resolution now? Oh wow, it works! And the desktop background is back. Oh, there's the option to change the resolution. It works! But now I can't open the start menu. I can't even right-click to open advanced options. Can we do Windows R? We can. Open the shared drive? Yep. So, can we restore the backup now? Wait, open with 7-zip, not with Windows Explorer. And select everything, extract to the root of the C drive, and here goes nothing. Yeah, replace everything, if it can. Perhaps I should have run this as administrator. Cannot open, access denied. Let's find 7-zip here, 7-zip file manager, run as administrator. Okay, it's done, but there are a lot of errors. Let's repeat that with 7-zip as administrator. Okay, still some errors, but fewer than last time. Now, can we restart without crashing? Still can't open the start menu. Oh, but now we can open this. So, restart. Okay, we're at a blank screen. Not sure if it's booting up or anything. Let's see if there's any drive activity. Oh, never mind, it restarted. So we might actually not be able to save this installation. Oh, there's the mouse cursor, but I think that's from my host OS. Yeah, I'm afraid this installation is done for. There's a reason why you shouldn't try this. Is it gonna do the automatic repair? Yep, now we see the boot screen. But is it gonna work? I have my doubts. Diagnosing PC. Automatic repair. The PC did not start up correctly. Choose restart to restart the PC. Well, we know what that's gonna do. Can we do a startup repair? Here it is. Attempting repairs. Startup repair cannot repair your PC. Can we even read that log file? It's probably not helpful. So yeah, there's your answer. At least this time, you cannot repair a destroyed Windows installation. Let's try safe mode just for fun. Nope, it's just automatically gonna go through the automatic repair. You can put the Windows installation disk, but it's not gonna do any repair installation. You pretty much have to format, deleting everything and reinstall. And I'm gonna try editing this video on Windows 7 as well. I installed Kden Live, an older version. But I'm not gonna upload it for Windows 7 for obvious reasons. I will transfer the video to my computer with a supported OS and upload it from there. How about we extract the backup files to the offline Windows installation while it's not booted up? Because we can still map the virtual disk, but of course we have to mount it not in read-only mode. This option should be used with extreme care. I'm afraid we've already thrown extreme care out the window, so let's continue. So we'll try unzipping the backup files again, except we'll do it while the machine is shut down. We don't seem to have permission to perform something. Maybe run 7-zip as administrator again. Nope, even as administrator, some files cannot be replaced. Maybe we could mess around with the file permissions or something, but I'm afraid it's not gonna help very much. So let's try skipping. It's probably gonna skip everything. Okay, copy and replace. I think it's done. I wasn't paying much attention. So this is our last hope. If this doesn't work, nothing will. Aside from a proper reinstallation of the OS, of course. Power on. This is not a good sign. We still can't see the boot screen. And nothing. Is this log file gonna tell anything? Let's find out. Shut down. There's the log file. Let's scroll to the end. There's what's wrong. System registry corrupted. That figures. That would be in the config folder, I think. But we can't access it. It obviously has special permissions. I think we've messed with this installation long enough. It was a silly experiment as usual. I don't think there's any need to waste any more time with this. RIP Windows 10 installation 2025 to 2025. Thank you for watching.